We know, what we do know is we had five victims. Four of them were Morgan students. One was not. One has already been released from the hospital. The young people, I can tell you, that went through this trauma were extremely, extremely cooperative. They helped us every way that we could, especially when we had to clear their buildings and come into their dorm rooms. That went as smoothly as we could. We know that there was at least more than one person with a weapon. The problem is the ballistics has to tell us how many guns there were that were shot. We know that there was, it looks like it was probably a dispute between two smaller groups, and then one individual was a target of two individuals who had weapons. We don't believe that individual was hit. We believe the five victims who were struck were unintended targets, and we do know a third person pulled a weapon, but we don't know how many of those were fired because mainly all the ballistics was relatively the same, and we have to do a deeper dive with our ATF partners.
As you all know, last night we had a very, very difficult and tragic and traumatic situation at Morgan State University. Our heart aches for the entire Morgan community, especially those directly impacted and their families, and we're wishing for all a speedy recovery. It's another, yet another example in now the extremely long line of campus and school shootings that have taken place across this country in communities and cities alike, rural and urban. The horrific act of violence is a sickening a reminder for all of us of how commonplace these incidents have become. And we must end the epidemic of gun violence in our communities once and for all, but that cannot be done alone at the local level. In Baltimore, we have taken thousands of illegal guns off the street and continue implementing a comprehensive public health-based approach to dealing with violence in our reduction strategy, holding those who pull the trigger accountable, those who traffic guns accountable, holding manufacturers accountable, but we cannot continue to ignore the elephant in the room, and that is that we must address the nationwide proliferation of guns in the hands of people in our communities that should not have them, and that this is a national issue that has to be addressed at the national level. We need partnership from every single level of government in order for us all to see the disease of gun violence meet its end. We're going to continue to do our part in improving public safety and holding people accountable and building public health approaches and everything within power of local government to impact this longstanding public health challenge. We are mobilizing the resources that we have at our disposal to offer support and embrace the entire Morgan community, particularly the students and the staff who are reeling from the trauma of having this happen right on their campus. From Monsey stabilization teams to our partners in the White House, particularly the new Office of Gun Violence Prevention that spoke directly with myself and President Wilson this morning, and community groups, we are receiving an outpouring of support for these students, their families, and the Morgan community, and we're making those connections this morning.